have to know. Please, for the purpose of this, just tell us your name and your portfolio.
Okay, my name is Dr. Eyorok Edet. Okay. I'm the assistant secretary of the Kerelem community.
Okay. Right, so we had this a little leadership tussle in the community. Can you throw give us a background story to it?
Well, the thing is that we heard of the leadership tussle, but in the first place, that wouldn't have arisen because we have a substantive head.
Okay.
We're still alive. And for it to happen this way and the leadership tussle in the military, if you try to unseat the president or the head of state, is against the military rule, is against the law, and you have to go in for it.
So,
yeah, you have to be court martialed. And I was very surprised, like others, that this one man who paraded himself, who said he had been asked to come and take over the leadership of the Kerelem, which has never happened. The Kerelem community is an ancestral community, it's an autonomous community. In the event of the death of the head, there is a legal, a traditional procedure that has to be followed. And normally is family by family.
Okay.
And if that is the case, when we get to the bridge, we'll cross, but it has not been the case. So we don't have, when we heard the rumor, we acted it. When we acted on that, we heard from Mahobawan, Princess Mahopo, who told the man in question, came to her to seek for advice, to seek for counsel that he has been asked to come and take over in Africa. And the woman asked her, how, why?
Asked by who?
By who?
By the, is it the calling chief, Ekpo Konepo?
Who is chief?
I wouldn't know him.
Okay, now you said there's a procedure and it's family by family.
This said, a procedure.
This said person, is it the turn of his family
it's
to
not.
Produce the next?
It's not.
Have they ruled before?
They have not. It's not.
So don't you think his actions or his family actions is based on the fact that they have not
been
given
opportunity
to
Even if they've been denied opportunity, the current village head is still in charge. He's still in charge. So that wouldn't have even come into the picture because we have not lost the man. The man is still alive. He's still in charge.
So is there any chance that if, in case of eventuality, that family will be given an opportunity to rule?
Well, it's beyond me for now because it's a council decision. Okay. It's a current town council decision.
So, what's the council's decision and how do they intend to handle
it? Can you introduce yourself to
us? My name is Okoni Ifeoyasa. Obviously, I'm a youth leader here in the Kerelem community.
Okay. Sir, we have been kept abreast with the recent leadership tussle in your community. We want to find out, is there a traditional way of handling this particular crisis?
Yes, sir. Yeah,
sir, can you give us a
background? We have a family that come up, make it community, a Kerelem community. As we did before, we choose ourselves a leader. This present one, we choose ourselves a leader who is a village head. We take it to the governor, which is municipality that cover us. Then from there, we took it to the government. Then they give us a certificate. So now we heard that because of the rumors, public that we are here, no one to suspect any village head. Our, you have a village head here. He's still alive, still working with us. Even if he's late, it's us here going to make our village head. So we are standing here, I'm standing by the head of youth. We are also prepared. We don't want to take the violence to our hands. That's why we say, let's come to the public and let the public know what is going on. So we are here. We are ever ready. Who that they want to send to us.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I'm Imam Olekudet. I'm the secretary of the community.
Which particular community?
The Kerelem. Secretary of the Kerelem community.
Okay.
Ms. Can you kindly explain to us about the part of the meeting that we heard you talking about the village head issues and that? Can you give us throw more light on that?
Yes, we heard that the Pobas family selected somebody to send to Kurinum as a village head. And the person himself even went to Princess Okpo Edensa to also notify her that he has been picked or selected by Pobas family to come and be the village head of the Kurinum. And that cannot happen because that is not the procedure.
How many families are there in the Kurinum?
Okay, we have up to 14 families.
Is it the turn of the Pobasi family to produce the next village head?
No, Pobasi does not have a legal standing. Pobasi family is a family which one way or the other is also connected to Kurinum. But the Kurinum is a village gazetted by the government. And as such, it is a community, it is a village that have to select their leader. Nobody can be imposed on the community or the village as a village.
Is this a collective decision by this community, this council? What you just said, Nada?
Yes.
It's a collective decision by the council?
Yes.
Okay, so what's the stand of the community right now?
The stand of the community is that the person at whose head, Mr. Ibu Ogunibu, cannot be. Our village is still alive, certificated by the government, and even if we need another village head, we have to select the village head by ourselves, for ourselves.
Already, we know that this is a conflict situation, so how do you want to address it? How does the community leadership want to manage this particular crisis?
Okay, we are a peace-loving people, law-abiding citizens, so we want to follow due process in handling it.
Which are?
One, the Ibobas family, who are at the background, have to be notified with the decision of the community. And then the security agencies are also to be notified, because what they are trying to do is going to cause a breach of peace. This is conduct that can lead to breach of peace, which we don't want that to happen.
So as a secretary of the council, can you make a statement that can be quoted anywhere?
Fine. My statement, my stand as Prime Secretary is that Ikurinam is a village. We have the village council. Our decisions are to be taken by us. If we need a leader, we have to choose a leader for ourselves. Nobody can impose anybody on us as a leader because they don't have such rights. That's my stand.
Thank you. Okay. Okay.
So, why do you think that this other person is parading himself like in the village?
Because if you send somebody to somebody, you have to send it a letter. Go and tell that, told those people that, oh, we have sent you to be, we have sent you to represent us there.
But in time past, how do you elect your village head? Is it the same procedure this man is using?
No. You cannot stay outside and send a village head to the village. Already we have got a village head which the government knows about it and gave him a certificate.
Like I was saying, in time past, how do you get your village head?
Mm-hmm. How we get our village head is that we select it within ourselves and then take it to the governor to approve and give him a certificate.
So the letter the man came with is not from the government, it's from an individual.
Yes, sir.
The letter the man.
This other man is coming with.
This other man that is coming in said they sent her, sent him to us.
Sent him.
You see, at the album of Calabar, we do not know who sent him because one didn't present a letter for us to see the letter and see the person that signed the letter to confirm.
Have you confirmed from the Obam of Calabar or a higher authority?
Well, we cannot do that because even the Obam of Calabar cannot select a village head for any village. People are living there to know who will be good for them.
Okay. Thank you.